Welcome, Commissioner. People are aware of your responsibilities for the digital agenda and your concerns with equality and human rights from your own accord throughout your career. And we are also very much aware that last week, at the end of last week, you were specifically talking about fighting disinformation, which may be part of what you want to share with us. So welcome, and we look forward to your contribution.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Please. Okay. So thank you very much. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, dear representatives of the member states, dear members of the private sector of the civil society, I would like to start by expressing my pleasure and my honor to be here with you in this beautiful city of The Hague. And at the same time, it's always a pleasure and honor to address the European Internet Governance Community. So I would like to start by saying at the same time that for me, Eurodig is and has been one of the most advanced regional platforms to discuss digital policy issues, but at the same time offering precious inputs to the global IGF. So we can be proud of the progress made in the last few years, thanks to your relentless work and commitment. The debate on the future of internet governance and its institutions is now high on the European and global political agendas, as reminded in the IGF conference from last November in Paris. What a long way we have come since the first World Summit on Information Society and the Tunis Agenda in 2005. The idea that the technical community, civil society, academia, and private sector all have a role to play in the governance of a core infrastructure like the internet was really groundbreaking. This idea is now mainstream. However, having been right once, it's not enough. We need to be lucid about current and future challenges on the concrete implementation of this multi-stakeholder principle. So, ladies and gentlemen, 14 years after, we are indeed entering a new phase. A new phase where a synthesis is possible between historical oppositions. Opposition between the multi-stakeholder model and the multilateral approach, between bottom-up and top-down, between a purely market-based approach and state intervention. Indeed, I believe a synthesis is not only possible, but also much needed. The entire digital landscape has radically changed since 2005. By then, the internet had only 1 billion users, mostly in the Western countries, but nowadays more than a half of the world's population is online, three times more people than in 2005. But more importantly, we are still far from achieving the initial promises of an open, free, and decentralized internet, and new issues have become quite prominent. Trust is lacking. Some powerful online platforms have developed into gatekeepers and holders of our data. The digital divide still exists for key online services like e-health, e-government, or online financial services. And the quest for privacy and cybersecurity are far from being guaranteed. And increasingly, the development of internet is raising fundamental political and ethical issues about human agency, trust, inclusion, fairness, sustainability, or even mental health problems linked to digital addiction. Beside the management of the core internet resources and infrastructure, Tackling these issues will require political decisions via domestic and international regulations. But more than ever, cooperation is needed to foster a convergence of approaches and to combat the fragmentation of the Internet. Digital cooperation will also be paramount as a global public good to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals, to ensure the security of online interactions, to guarantee privacy and the control of personal data, to rebuild trust in technology that is eroding fast, and to prevent that digital technologies are used to exploit, oppress, and control. In this context, what should be our immediate response to these challenges? First, I think that we should strongly support an evolution of the multi-stakeholder models towards more efficiency. The lack of a clear agenda and tangible outcomes, insufficient participation of key stakeholders, including governments and the private sector, as well as insufficient funding, are key issues that need to be urgently addressed. Here, I would like to take the opportunity to welcome the work realized by the UN High-Level Panel in their report, The Age of Digital Interdependence, submitted to the Secretary-General, Antonio Guterres, on the 9th of June. In particular, I would like to highlight, as the report states it, that we need to make sure that all perspectives from all stakeholders are taken into account. We need a broad diversity of voices around the table, including, in particular, the developing countries. Yes, the highly anticipated conclusions of the panel confirm that digital has now become mainstream and has permeated all aspects of society. We also note with interest the three architectures proposed in the report, and these are thought-provoking models that can guide future work to make internet governance more efficient and more effective. This debate is not new, and we at the European Commission have always made it clear that we support a more empowered internet governance forum with a greater role for governments to better reflect the increasing role of digital regulation and to align actors' behaviors and interests. Personally, I have already put forward a set of concrete proposals to improve the IGF with three key points. Building a strategic multi-year program with a view to agree on shared principles and norms on key policy issues. Second, giving a stronger role to the national and regional initiatives, not only in terms of capacity building and awareness raising, but also in the elaboration of shared norms and principles. And third, ensuring a stronger involvement of internet innovators to inform the policy debate and work on practical solutions to policy issues. This is our proposal for more effective internet governance forum, and they could be tested in the current configuration and quickly implemented without needing a profound reform, and in parallel with the ongoing debate on the preferred model for internet governance. Second response, we must focus on technology governance. Cutting-edge digital technologies, such as artificial intelligence or blockchain, will not only change the way the internet works, they will bring the digital transformation to another dimension. They will shape our economies, our societies, and the individuals themselves. This comes from a simple fact. Technology is not value-free or value-neutral. On the contrary, it is permeated by the values its developers incorporate or fail to incorporate in the design of technologies, interfaces, or software. And all these questions are central for our future, and I think that we can agree they are highly political. Indeed, this is about choosing the type of society we want to live in. Do we want a society that is at the service of people, or a society where people are manipulated by digital actors with the help of artificial intelligence and big data? Do we want a society that protects children, or a society that overwhelms them and addicts them? Do we want a society where companies escape competition, or a society where businesses operate on a level playing field? These are critical questions for our common future, and Europe's approach to answer them is different from some other approaches. And I think that we can be proud of Europe, because we are certainly the first to raise these issues and to put forward a comprehensive approach with an attempt to ensure that innovation is driven by an ethical, sustainable, and human-centric internet. The European Union has not shied away from its responsibility, and we did not hesitate to regulate digital technologies and services when our values, such as privacy, security, openness, or fairness, were at stake. And make no mistake, the development of internet regulation is only at its beginning. The events of the last few years, be they attacks by malware, the illegal use of the personal data of users of social networks, the increase of illegal content and violence online, or the dissemination and spread of false information, remind us that self-regulation of the internet has clear limits. Of course, we should look forward, not backwards, and bring innovation into our policy making. Emerging technologies require innovative approaches to policy and regulation. To this end, we support the experimentation of new, more agile or holistic ways of doing policy in the internet era, in particular by better articulating different policy instruments, from innovation policy to co-regulation and regulation. New approaches can be tested in particular at local level with the help of regulatory sandboxes. We also think that policies can be made effective and innovation-friendly without losing legal certainty. But beyond regulation, we have established soft governance mechanism in the form of multidisciplinary and multi-stakeholder expert groups, which will provide guidance for us as policymakers. In this way, we have two examples. On one side, this kind of group already have a great result. It's about the ethics guidelines on artificial intelligence. In the other one, it was the launch of the International Association for Trusted Blockchain Applications. We consider those multi-stakeholder expert groups as pioneers of this innovative approach, which could be replicated on the global internet governance scene, bringing experts from many different fields to the table, together with governments, online providers, and civil society. So multi-stakeholder and multidisciplinary policy formulation are needed to to address the wide range of societal challenges raised by digital technologies. And Europe will continue to work to develop international partnerships with like-minded countries, covering innovation actions, regulatory alignment, for example, in the field of data protection and internet governance. This is why we, as a European Union, we already put in place several dialogues with third countries, because the aim is very clear: to enhance our cooperation on digital matters and to see how we can really shape this digital transformation together. We already have some important common initiatives with the Mediterranean region, with the sub-Saharan African countries. Yesterday I participated to the European Development Days, and that was a great occasion to popularize the recommendations of the report of the Digital Task Force. I'm one of the co-chairs. But another important region for me is Western Balkans. We already have a very good cooperation with them, especially in the framework of the Southeast Dialogue for Internet Governance. And we have really to continue to promote this regional cooperation. And this naturally takes me to the third response. We need to look forward and build on Europe's leadership. I'm deeply convinced that Europe has a fundamental role to play in the coming years, leading the way towards a new approach for internet governance based on inclusiveness, effectiveness, and relevance. An approach that promotes our fundamental values of respect for human dignity, freedom, democracy, equality, the rule of law, and respect for human rights. There is a clear opportunity ahead of us. The next European Commission will be in a position to take a clear and strong position in the face of the significant challenges that exist in this field of internet governance. Concretely, this could be the basis for a meaningful European contribution in response to the important issues raised by the UN Secretary General's high-level panel on digital cooperation. This is where I also see a fundamental role for Eurodig and its community. So I welcome your initiative of establishing intersessional work on specific topics and to contribute together to a European response to the UN high-level panel report. This approach needs to be expanded to allow Eurodig to feed in ideas and proposals in the global discussion. I strongly encourage the community to bring this forward and further explore such mechanisms in the future, focusing each time on the most pressing issues for digital policy. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have no time to lose. Digital is moving fast, and we need to set up the mechanism for an efficient cooperation at global level. So let's build on the Declaration of Digital Interdependence of the UN High-Level Panel, which highlights how digital developments will largely depend on our joint commitment towards a shared vision of a sustainable, fair, inclusive, and equitable future. So with the momentum created by the UN High-Level Panel and the next IGF in Berlin, we can launch this reform movement here in Europe. And let's do it together. Let's continue our joint efforts to put our European values at the heart of global internet governance agenda. Let's be inspired here in The Hague by the motto of the Netherlands, Je maintiendrai, as the expression of our common determination to ensure that new freedom and possibilities enabled by the Internet are supporting and not undermining the heritage of the Enlightenment and our common European fundamental values. You can count on our full support to do so. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Commissioner. Thank you for your good words. Thank you for putting people first. I think you'll find a lot of people in the room who very much support that. And your call is very well in very good hands. So we'll take it forward from here. And we hope to see you at IGF, of course, as well. So,
thank you. You can count on my support. Thank you.
We can count on your support. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
So, and well, Marjolein, thanks to the Commissioner, just to remind you that we start again at 2 o'clock.
At 2 o'clock. It's lunchtime. I think everybody's time for lunch. Another time, the current program is in the on the website. So if you want to know the current program, 2 o'clock over here or at the sessions, and have a good time. Thank you, Maarten.
Thank you, Marjolein.